Remember walking through a crowded park on a beautiful day?
He grew up right here, right down the street.
Just 3 weeks ago, before there was no place but home, actors Sarah Jessica Parker and Matthew Broderick showed off one of their favorite spots.
We're in the famous Narelda Park in New York, like it, Washington Square Park, the heart of the village, right?
The park holds 30 years of memories for this longtime couple.
All these newfangled buildings everywhere.
Shared memories they don't often share.
We were just dating. I ran into Matthew and he was on a payphone, and I was carrying a mattress with my friend John.
That was the beginning of a long relationship, but a pretty short story.
The two of you, how quickly did you know?
It was complicated.
It was?
I don't remember.
We're not going to talk about this part. This is the part we don't talk about.
But
we're not practiced.
What's your answer to the question?
From the first time we were together, we've never been apart since. That's true. Sorry.
Lately, they're spending even more time together.
We've been watching Columbo at night. We've been playing a lot of games, a lot of cooking, a lot of laundry.
The couple, along with other artists, recently joined Rosie O'Donnell for a live-streamed benefit for the Actors Fund, a nonprofit.
I was walking on Broadway back when you could, and I saw the theater that you guys were going to open in.
Parker and Broderick were set to co-star in a revival of Neil Simon's Plaza Suite, but the very day they were to begin performances, theaters were shut down to slow the spread of COVID-19.
Hello, Sam.
Plaza Suite is one of the few new shows still expected to open someday.
Anytime you want to see one of my pictures.
I couldn't do that.
Why not?
I couldn't impose like that.
Just last month, the stars were playing to sold-out houses in Boston and getting set to bring the play to Broadway.
And of course, the plastic won't be.
For the first time since its hit run more than 50 years ago.
This is room 719.
Suite 719.
It's also the first time Broderick and Parker have acted together since they were married 23 years ago.
We had basically come to the conclusion without ever having said it that we will never really work together.
Yeah, every now and then somebody would say, you guys should do something together. And we'd say, what? And they'd say, I have an appointment.
And Parker had her own reason for hesitating.
Actually, what I felt was, oh God, no, really? Because you know each other in such a different way, but I think it has been incredibly pleasant.
Get out of my way.
She'll come out. Just talk nicely to her.
We already had nice talking. Now we're going to have door breaking.
Audiences have been delighted.
At the very beginning, as soon as Ms. Parker was revealed, they were just very, very happy to be here. And you can't help but feel reassured by that.
In this comedy about marriage, they appear as three different couples who check into the same Plaza Suite.
It's a simple question. How old are you?
I don't want to play.
Act one, Karen and Sam are celebrating an awkward wedding anniversary.
For God's sake, Mary. What are you so nervous about?
Act two, Jesse, a Hollywood producer hoping for sparks with his high school flame, Muriel.
That character is the most fun for you because of your getup.
I do have a really nice outfit. Where's Mimsy?
Promise you're not going to blame me?
Finally, Norma and Roy.
I didn't do anything, but I don't want to get blamed for it.
Parents of the bride, who's got cold feet.
They are moments away from handing off their daughter, who has locked herself in the bathroom.
Oh, Roy, don't!
Of course, it's a challenge to change characters multiple times in one night.
Get a doctor.
But Parker and Broderick are experienced actors, each with decades on stage and screen. Movie fans may still know him best from Ferris Bueller's Day Off.
Yeah. I like it 80% as much as they do.
And of course, she's most famous as the iconic Carrie Bradshaw on Sex and the City.
Damn. It would have been so cool if I hadn't looked back.
Would a young Carrie Bradshaw have dated Ferris Bueller?
I don't know if Ferris Bueller would have dated Carrie Bradshaw.
Well, one is DC and the other is Marvel.
Oh.
Broderick not only knows comic books, he's a devoted baseball fan, and so is she.
Before we had too many kids, we had a dream. We were going to, not too many kids. I mean, before we had so many children that
I think
rightfully took up our time, we had a dream before all the baseball stadiums changed. We were going to hit every single one in the country.
How many of them are there? There's children?
We have three.
That we know about.
No, we're sure. We're sure.
They have two girls, 10-year-old twins, and a 17-year-old son.
Actors, any of them? All of them?
Sounds like
yet.
One of them.
One of the
sounds
girls
like one of the girls.
It.
Yeah, which is an absolute surprise. Both but sides. She did clarify yeah. that the other day and said she wants to get her degree in education because she really wants to be a teacher. And I said, that's a fine and good idea. And then you can always go to acting school.
So these are funny conversations with a 10-year-old, you know? Yeah.
But she and the other...
I think you could pass the bar. Certainly.
They both started young. At 13, she was Annie. And at 17, he made his stage debut alongside his dad, the late actor James Broderick.
I'll be so happy to keep his dinner warm. Yeah.
That was her song in 1995's How to Succeed in Business Without Really Trying.
Happy to keep his dinner warm.
It was the only time they'd ever worked together before Plaza Suite.
Jay Pierpont.
Matthew Broderick would be the man you're singing about.
Yes.
Of course.
She was singing about Ponty.
Ponty.
Jay Pierpont Finch.
Yeah.
And Ponty. Oh, Ponty.
Great chemistry, both on stage and off.
I mean, we've spent more time together in the last 2.5, 3 months than we've spent since we were courting, really, sincerely.
What was I just doing?
Watching yourself like a hawk.
While they're still seeing a lot of each other, audiences will have to wait to see them live on stage. But homebound fans can still spend quality time with some old friends, Matthew Broderick and Sarah Jessica Parker.
We both feel so lucky, so privileged, because how many great actors who haven't had the sort of success that you think that they're deserving of? If you're not cognizant of that all the time, you're a fool and an ingrate. And I'm enormously grateful.